वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई हैव टेकन अ टॉपिक विच विल बी आई थिंक इट इज अबाउट फ्लेम फोटोमेट्री. आई एम नॉट गोइंग इन मच डिटेल इन थियोरेटिकल पार्ट, ओनली आई हैव कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड इन द लैब how you can perform an experiment, and also some theoretical knowledge is needed about the basic principles and its advantages, so that it will be helpful for the students in both practicals and also theory. As in this COVID situation, I expect that this may be a small helpful for the pharmacy students who are in this, even in Kuhas or in especially in also they may be useful in seventh semester. But anyway, I have not made for it. I just made commonly for even my international students who have asked from Ethiopia. They may also be useful. They can perform this as an experimental method of flame photometry. There are many experts might have given more in detail. You can go for a detailed instrumentation by means of your professors, and also we can ask with your teachers. I'm just sharing what's my experience and my knowledge which I have done in about 25 years back, and also presently also it is, the instrument is not changed, the same one. Anyhow, it can be used by the students. So see, that we have seen analysis, that is, for example, quantitative and qualitative analysis of various elements especially can be done by flame photometry and flame photometer. So you might have come across this, all this, first starting from the light wave, and also how the various UV visible, IR, NMR, and all this instrumentation you might have studied with the light, especially starting from the light when and falls on an organic molecule, how it changes in its molecular structure, especially it get excited and they come to the ground state and they emit visible light, and the light emission can be detected. So you might have studied about the Beer-Lambert's law, which is starting from the calorimetry and UV spectroscopy, and this is little from that we are just coming to an little advanced ionization, especially by means of combusting the sample. The flame gives different intensity of the color, different intensity in the color according to the concentration, which can be easily detected by a photo multiplier tube, and which can be converted into an electrical energy which can be detected. This is what the main basic principle we will discuss in about that, and also how to have a practical section very simply, because in this COVID situation it's not possible to perform together in a lab. So if you have an idea which I am telling you in a simple procedure and some instruments video when I show, I hope it will be helpful to the students. So if you have any doubt or any type of mistakes which I have done or I have not explained properly, you are most welcome to contact me by means of my mobile number, which is having WhatsApp, and also by email also it's possible for you to contact me. And also you can give your suggestions in my YouTube channel, so that I will improve myself to give more information which I can. So the principle of flame photometry is, first we should know, as I told, a little theoretical, I'm just giving some idea. That is the compound of the alkali and alkaline earth. Sodium, potassium, barium, lithium. So these metals which comes under group 2 dissociates into atoms when introduced into flame. So when you are having a sample which contain this alkaline matters like sodium, potassium, barium, lithium, calcium, this all type of alkali metals which can give, when it is dissociate into atoms when it is introduced in the flame. This is the basic concept behind, you should understand. So a sample contain this type of elements are introduced by means of an LPG gas, and it has been combusted, or it is made into a flame which has some intensity of light which can be detected, or it can be converted into an electric energy by means of a photo multiplier or photo tube which can be detected. By that you can find out how much amount of this element is present in the particular sample. Understand? That is what the main idea. And some of these atoms further get excited to even higher levels. As we have studied in fluorimetry, there is phosphorescence, fluorescence, these all the theoretical knowledge you have to just have an idea, because when I come to one session in the future, I can give you some idea also about how a molecule, when for example fluorescence, you may be there sometimes some objects, some compounds having an intensity to absorb UV light, and after a delay they may emit an visible light. That's what you might have studied in fluorescence. Like that you can see emission. So here also some of these atoms which is present in the sample further get excited to even give higher levels of there. There is, they have ground level, excited level. So there will be vibrational energy. And you might have studied all these things, vibrational energy, which can be even shown in various molecules, which can give various stages of the electronic configuration of an atom. So these atoms are getting excited even to the higher levels. So, but these atoms are not stable at higher levels. So what happened? Hence these atoms emit radiation even returning back to the ground state. Returning back to the ground state when you are combusted. So that is the same thing even happens in fluorescence also, but we are not mixing up with that. But this one is purely by means of introducing in the flame. That is the first sentence we have mentioned, that combusting or flame by means of burning these elements in the sample, that means the atom further get excited to even to the higher levels, but they are not stable there. They will return to back to the ground state, and there it emits the radiation. This radiation generally lies in visible region, as you have seen in the fluorescence also, it will be in the visible region. That is why fluorescent materials, they will absorb the UV light and they emit. So that's why, that's the same thing even here also, the same thing, it is a visible radiation which can be easily detected from the, you might have studied the range of the visible radiation for 400 to 800 nanometer. The visible radiation in the Wibgia region, it may give some different colors which can be identified which element, and also the intensity of that particular emission of that color radiation can be detected, and it can give you the detail about the concentration of the particular elements present in the given sample. So these radiation generally lies in a visible region of the spectrum. So each of alkali and alkaline atom metals have a specific wavelength. So see here, I have given the wavelength also in the visible radiation, which can be emitted by the elements like sodium. It can give 589 nanometer in yellow color. So when you are example, we have taken sodium chloride for our experiment. Potassium chloride can be taken for potassium identification. And you can see it is potassium means 766 nanometer in violet color flame can be observed, and the intensity of the color which is obtained by the flame combustion from the flame photometry can give the detection, can give the amount of potassium present in the sample. Barium chloride can be used, and it can give a flame in an intensity of lime green, it is 554 nanometer. Calcium, even calcium chloride can be used, and it can give orange flame, which is, it is detected in the nanometer of 622 nanometer. And even lithium chloride, lithium can also be identified. This all comes under the group 2 of the inorganic chemistry. You might have studied these elements can be detected in the presence of any type of sample, and the amount can be detected very clearly. And lithium, you can see 670 nanometer red color flame can be identified. So for certain concentration ranges, the intensity of the emission is directly proportional, the intensity of the emission, that means the color intensity is directly proportional to the number of atoms, concentration, number of atoms returning to the ground state. Even you have to remember about this, number of atoms will give you the concentration, amount of the atom present in the sample. And the light emission is in the turn proportional to the concentration of the sample. So the light emission automatically, the number will be increased, means the light emission and the intensity of the light can be detected, the emitted light can be detected by a photo multiplier, which can be kept as a detector in the instrument, and you can identify, you can amplify, it can be converted into electrical energy, or it can be converted, amplified, and it can be energy can be detected, and so that you can find out this very easily, and you can find out the concentration of the sample by means of a standard curve. Standard curve means, again, you may be knowing, it's a very simple method which can be easily identified. We want to know about this emitted wavelength. Why? Because you know very well, always in an instrument, it is necessary for you to use as a monochromator, because you have to, the light will be polychromatic light. When it is emitted from a flame, or it from sunlight, or whatever the source, from a light or a bulb. So you have to make a lambda max, that is the component which you are responsible, or which you are needed for you to find out the concentration. That particular nanometer only you have to select, and you have to make it to fall, and you have to select that nanometer to fall on the photo multiplier tube. Then only you can find out what is that particular intensity of that particular emission of the light. So that's why we are giving this emitted wavelength. Understand? So you can see this. This is the parts of the particular instrument. This is just a schematic diagram. We'll see the original instrument. That time you will be having more idea. So what are the parts? First you should know, compressor is very important. Compressor. There should be a compressor, and also it should have, say for example, it is 0.5 kilometer, the kilogram per the meter square pressure should be there to suck the sample in the instrument. Very important. So that is a compressor should be there in the instrument, which is adjusted and which is controlled by the student and by the person who is operating for that particular experiment. So first one is, you should know compressor. A fuel supply, for example, compressed fuel supply, compressed air supply. So, or you can say compressor, you can say. So, first, this one is fuel supply, and this one is compressed air supply, or a compressor can be used, because a pressurized compressor, if you fix there, then only you can see the sample area where a small capillary tube will be kept. in a plastic capillary tube will be kept in the instrument, which will suck the sample to the area where it is atomized, sprayed, atomized, atomization, that is spraying, small nozzle which will be present there, where the mixing of the both the compressed fuel, that means LPG gas, and the air which will be spraying this particular sample, there you can get a burner which can make the flame. So according to the sample containing, suppose if you keep a distilled water, double distilled water without any elements, there may not be any color will be seen, because you cannot see, there will not be any feed, there is no elements, the element, there will not be any type of visible radiations of color which we shown in the previous slide, cannot be seen. But if there is any type of, for example, normal tap water, if you add, there will be a lot of sodium on potassium, sodium will be there especially. So whatever, you will get a yellow flame. You can see that is, for example, in your home, usually they will say if there is an yellow flame, there is lot of dirts are there, and there will be lot of your tap water and your boiled cooking material might have fall on your burner, and it will cause sometimes wastage of the gas, and so that they will call the particular for serviceman to clean it and to have an pure bluish flame. So bluish flame will change when you are adding tap water which contain these elements, group 2 elements. So you can see that is the flame, and after that there is a lens to converge. A convex lens will be kept to converge the intensity to you are going to find out the intensity of the light which is emitted when you are keeping a sample. So that need a lens, converging lens. So you are using a convex lens in the instrument, and there is a slit. What do you mean by slit? Slit allows a particular ray to fall into a very small slit or a band of light which can fall on a filter. What do you mean by filter? Filters, you might have studied about in your basic analytical chemistry. First, the teacher might have told you about to study about the monochromators. So in the monochromators, you can see filters, and you might have prisms, gratings, and you can see there is filters also comes under monochromators, and grating also it comes advanced. So what is this use of this filter, monochromators, prisms, and in your smaller classes also you might have seen this prism. Your teacher in physics, they might have shown you from a light which comes from the sunlight, when fall in the prism you can see the VGR color, how you are getting that visible radiation. So you see the prism can also makes the monochromatic. For example, the polychromatic light which come from the sunlight, when falls on a monochromator like prism, it is converted into a single or a monochromatic light. The visible rays can also be seen from 400 to 800 nanometers. How many colors are there is clearly you can observe by means of your teacher example. That same thing, even grating, there will be grooves will be there. It can be controlled by means of certain arrangements, such that which nanometer to which nanometer you need in UV visible or UV instruments, they used to use grating as a monochromator. And use a filter, initially if you want to filters are, for example, when you want to have a filter of sodium, for example, sodium is giving yellow color. So and potassium is giving violet color. So you need only the yellow color radiation should fall on our photo multiplier. So that's why you have to discard all the other emissions, unwanted emissions. So only you want to see the concentration of sodium. So the filter which you are using, it will allow only the nanometer which is, for example, you just see here, that is for example the yellow color, how much at the nanometer, I want to show you, see, for example, it is 589 nanometer, or you can see nearing to 590 nanometer, which can be made into this filter. This filter will allow only this if it is a sodium, or if it is an potassium, you have to 766 nanometer filter have to be selected. If it is an barium, you have to 554 nanometer lime green have to be selected. So that is the place where the student should know. So I told you to remember about controlling the compressor and controlling the fuel and selecting the filter in the instrument is very important. So you can see here next to a filter, what is there? You can see there it is that photo detector where that is cathode which can receive the photons and it can be converted into amplified into an electrical energy and which can be displayed into a digital reading. Do a digital reading. How much the amps, how much it is produced. By that, the intensity of the color which is produced by the flame can be detected. So this is the theoretical knowledge which I can give you, and you can go for the parts. Again, I have detailed what I have explained, the parts of the flame, as I told, just we have discussed. I'm just going on reading. We don't want to spend much time by means of this. We have to go for the practical session and the videos. A simple flame photometer consists of the following component: the source, flame, a burner, which we have discussed. In the flame photometer is the source of the flame. It can be maintained at a constant temperature. The temperature of the flame is one of the critical factor in flame photometry. And nebulizer, which can spray, as we are told, nebulizer, which takes the sample through a capillary tube, and the compressed air nebulizer, which sprays, is used to send a homogeneous solution in the flame at the balanced rate. And you can see optical system. What is that optical system? That is the detector. Very important system, which consists of what all the things? There is a convex lens. There is a mirror and a convex lens. The convex mirror transmits the light emitted from the atom. Maybe sodium, maybe potassium, according to the experiment. And the convex mirror also helps to focus the emission to the lens. The lens helps to focus the light to the point or the slit. And that is the very important to the slit. And then comes to the simple color filter. After that, it comes to the filter. Filter, I told, it has to be selected according to the sample which you have kept. The reflection from the mirror passes through the slit, which is a small slit which gaps through that and reaches the filter, and the filter will isolate or it monochromate or it will change the wavelength to the measurement, whichever the wavelength, if it is 6, if it is 600, if it is 700 or 800, according to the color which you are selecting. For example, if it is sodium, yellowish color, that is 688 or 690 nanometer, 590 nanometer can be selected. So this, the reflection from the mirror passes through the slit and reaches the filter. The filter will isolate the wavelength to be measured from the irrelevant emission, because there will be lot of other emissions will be there. So the slit will control only a small point of emission will fall on the photo detector. Photo detector, we have to study in detail. You might have studied about the detector. What is the photo multiplier tube, photo tube, how the cathode works and how the anodes works, when the multiple photo multiplier, these all things you have to refer your basic knowledge about. The analytical chemistry instrumentation is very important. The intensity of the radiation emitted by the flame is measured by photo detector. Here, the emitted radiation by the photo detector, here emitted radiation is converted to an electrical signal, as we have discussed about it, and with the help of photo detector. These electrical signals are directly proportional to the intensity of the light. So you see this instrument, it is just a small video about the instrument. You can see this instrument is available in most of the colleges, and this is the, you can see there is a knob which is touching, is actually that is the filter. You can change it by sodium or potassium. The reading will be shown there. And you can see the distilled water first you have to keep in the tube which is shown, and it will suck the tube by means of a pressurized compressor which is kept there. And you can adjust the knob, coarse and fine will be there, and you have to make it zero. And after that you can go for higher concentration, or you can just, it is an example they are shown, it's a tap water he is keeping. You see the tap water, it suddenly it rises to 21. So that means it contains sodium and potassium. This is a small instrument just he has shown, and you can see this is another instrument which is having little more sophisticated, not sophisticated, it has little more filters can be adjusted by in the friend itself, and there is some calibration can be done. So how the calibration done? First you have to always keep the distilled water at zero and higher concentration to 100 and make your standard curve an unknown, and you can find out the concentration, unknown concentration. That's what, very simple experiment. And how to operate is a very important, and how to connect this LPG gas and how to prepare dilutions of your standard solution is a very important part in flame photometry. And see here, and in this instrument you can see first he was just showing the flame, but it is not necessary you have to make this yellow flame this much high. And you can see from the lens which is given from there, there will be M-shaped blue flame, M-shaped, usually it is zigzag, they used to say zigzag M flame can be seen very clearly, and it can be noticed in that. And first you have to mention, you see here, this is the standard flask where you have to make a stock solution and then you have to make the dilutions. That is a very important. So usually they are microgram per ml concentrations are allowed, and it will be easy for to perform. If it is more concentrated also, it's very difficult for you to make a standard curve. So you see, first he was just taking a distilled water and he was calibrating it to zero. And you can see he has, this is this instrument, they have the capillary tube. You can see, just to show you the capillary tube, how it is just a plastic capillary tube which is present in the nebulizer, which can be connected, and it will suck by means of controlling a pressurized compressor. Compressor is there, another video also I have taken, what do you mean by compressor? And then you will get a reading, and you can see that, and you go for the fine and the coarse adjustment, and by that you have to calibrate, and you can select the filter first, whether you are going to do sodium or potassium or calcium or barium or lithium, you have to decide. And then if you have taken sodium, he has taken as an example, and he is just adjusting the fine knob, and he was making it into zero by means of keeping a double distilled water. And it is possible for you to go for a zero reading. And then you can go for even in this instrument, it is possible for you to go for higher concentrations. Next, after making it into zero, you have to make a higher concentration. That is this higher concentration, you have to take, you have to keep it in a small beaker, 10 ml beaker can be used, or even sometimes in the next experiment, next video, what they are doing in the college, they have done with directly with a small standard flask also. And so that this he was saying about low concentration and the high, the difference in the concentration, it shows even blank you can make it into zero. That means double distilled water can be, you have to take, and it can be made into zero. Zero reading adjustment by means of taking the blank. If there is no, in your instrument it is not shown blank, or there is only coarse and fine, it's not, it's no need to worry about that. Take a distilled water which you are going to use as a solvent for all the dilutions, that distilled water you take and you make, set the zero, and make the highest concentration you take, you make a series of concentration. How to prepare I will show you, and that it will be the maximum that you have to adjust for 100, or then you can see other all concentrations can be easily identified and make a standard graph. And unknown, when you keep in that same place of the capillary tube, and you will get a reading, and that reading extrapolating from the graph of the y-axis. In the x-axis you have to take the concentration. You small simple graphical method can be used for standard curve method, can be used for finding the this identification of the concentration. This is what you can see, this instrument. And you can see the next one is, I want to tell about the dilution. Preparing dilution is a very, very important factor in the experiment of this flame photometry. So you have to take a digital and a analytical balance, which is shown here. This is the air which is should not interfere with your weighing. So weigh accurately 100 milligram. You can see, you can weigh accurately a 100 milligram of sodium chloride. Because we are going to perform the sodium chloride experiment, and so that you can see we can sodium chloride. Just a minute, I will show you. This is that sodium chloride. How you have to take the weight, you have to take, this is the dried sodium chloride, and then you have to go for dilutions. See here, and after weighing you transfer this exactly. You have to transfer properly. You have to transfer 100 milligram, just better 100 milligram, weigh properly, and make ready of your 100 ml standard flask, label properly, and transfer it, and by means of properly you transfer and make and dilute it with the distilled water or the blank which you are using, like a double distilled water, and make up the volume. Here this madam, I have taken the small standard flasks, like all of them are 10 ml standard flask she has taken. So she is taking 0.1 ml, 0.2 ml transferring. And when you take, you should have a calculation in your idea. 100 milligram dissolved in 100 ml, make up the volume in a standard flask. What will be the concentration of you should know of the solution. So 1 ml will have 1 milligram. 1 milligram means it is 1000 microgram. So when you take 1 ml from, when you take 0.1 ml from this stock solution, 0.1 ml, and if you are, what will be the concentration of the 0.1 ml? 1 ml will have 1 milligram, means 0.1 ml, if you take 0.1 ml. So it will be very, it will be, you can see, it will be 1 micro, it will be 10 microgram. So that's why she's preparing 1 microgram, 2 microgram, 3 microgram concentration. But that is very low concentration she is preparing. And also for fluorimetry, we have to go for very low concentrations is preferred. But when you see in normal lab procedure, we can prepare the same procedure like 100 milligram dissolved in, I'm just this 100 milligram dissolved, you have to weigh properly in a 100 ml standard flask. With distilled water you dilute it, shake properly, and make it that, confirm that it contain, and it's theoretically properly weigh 100 milligram, and just make up the volume, solubilize, and what is the concentration? 1 ml contains 1 milligram. So when you take 1 ml from that solution, pipette out and make it into another 100 ml standard flask, and make up the volume, what will be the concentration? So 1 ml will contain from that is 1 milligram, and 1 milligram when you make it to 100 ml again, you will get 10 microgram per ml concentration. So next flask, take 2 ml and make up the volume with 100 ml, you will get 20 microgram per ml. And next one, you can see 3 ml, 4 ml and 5 ml. So standard solutions can be prepared and keep ready. And see, and after keeping ready, make the flame. See that it should not be yellow color like this, it should be blue color, and like a zigzag, That is very important. So you have to select the sodium filter and keep the flame also very minimum, which is according to the procedure we have given the process how to find out. And this is the compressor, very important part. If it is not there, then you have to inform the particular serviceman to bring the compressor with the reading. You have to maintain the pressure 0.5 kilogram per, that is 0.5 kilogram per meter square is very important to maintain. So after that, you have to keep the distilled water, and you have to adjust for the double distilled water which you use for dilution, and you have to maintain it, keep into that the tube, and it will suck by means of your pressure, compressed pressure, and the flame. LPG gas fixing also very important. It is not shown in this picture. You can see in the lab there will be an LPG tube which will be fixed from the behind, and that also having a controlled knob. You have to control in a minimum capacity, and then you have to maintain into zero level by means of a distilled water, and take the highest concentration and make it into 100 reading. And so this is the two things which you have to maintain. Very, very simple experiment which can be done in your lab, and you can just perform very easily. Only thing is how to fix the LPG gas, how to fix the compressor, what is the use of the compressor, what is the use of the flame, what is the use of LPG, and how to maintain this two pressure and things which is very important. She is keeping directly the standard flask which is small, and she is finding out the reading, but you can keep even in a small beaker can be used for you to go for taking reading. So I have shown the video. Now we will go to the procedures how to prepare the solution. You see here solution. This is just I have drawn maximum which I can, and I just tell how you are preparing 100 milligram. You are taking sodium chloride, and you take standard flask, series of standard flask, at least minimum of 10 standard flask, wash, clear, dry, and keep ready with funnel. Understand this, the experiment should be done always perfectly by means of arranging. Planning is very important. Whenever doing a small experiment or big experiment, you have to take, it's my work, it's my important research, like that you should think. You should not think this is small, this is big. No, everything, a small experiment, like you see how it's difficult to prepare a food in the home. It's not an easy job. Your mothers are doing a great job. If they are the proposition which they add little more or less, it's very difficult to everybody is to take food. Understand, it affects everyone. So like that, a small work also you should give more importance. You should not think this is small, this is big, this is very big. No, when you do with sincerity and with loving towards the experiment, it will be give you good results, and that makes you more happy. Understand, even when I take, and if somebody says, oh, that's good class, it's nice for us, it was useful for us, if they say, then we'll be happy. If they say something, if it is wrong or something, then we'll correct it. So like that, you should make yourself such that you have to do something. So you take 100 milligram weigh properly, and 100 ml standard flask. What is the concentration? 1 milligram per ml. If you take 1 ml, it is contained 1 ml. So you see, this is a standard flask. From that, you take 1 ml, and then you make up the volume to 100 ml by the distilled water. What will be the concentration? 10 microgram per ml. Take 2 ml and add to the another standard flask. What is the concentration? 20 microgram per ml. 3 ml, transfer 3 ml, pipette out, and make up the volume in another 100 ml standard flask. It will be 30 microgram per ml. And take 4 ml and make it in another standard flask in 100 ml. Make up the volume with distilled water, 40 microgram per ml. And take 5 ml and by means pipette out, and in another standard flask, and make up the volume with 100. That will be 50 microgram per ml. So almost your work is over. Dilution and unknown you can prepare, and the teacher can give you an unknown sample from this any dilution mixing or something, and they'll tell you to find out. And because just an experimental method, just we are not going to take a sample also taken, and you can identify. But this is one experiment in a degree level we can perform. And so you see, this is the dilution. What you have to do, first after dilution preparation, switch on the digital display unit. You have seen the video, so you can switch on the digital display unit and switch on the compressor unit and set the air pressure 0.5 kilogram per meter square. The square is not properly mentioned here. Square, meter square, the pressure. Understand? So you remember what is the video which we have discussed. I can go a little faster also. I don't want to waste your time. People doesn't like to watch for many hours together. And so that's why I'm just little faster. I told the details in the video. So that will be helpful, I hope. If you are not seen, just go back and just watch it then. And you will understand very easily, very simple experiment. Understand? 0.5 kilogram per, you have to knob and you have to adjust the pressure. Very important. Control the knob. And switch on the gas also. Gas, which is LPG gas supply for combusting. Set the flame in the burner in a zigzag. Blue flame, zigzag. Like M from the lens, you can see zigzag line of the flame in a clear visible ray. And atomize means sprayer. That means a tube. You can see the a plastic tube, which that is a, or a capillary tube, which is coming from the atomizer. We can keep the distilled water, and you have to set zero. That is what we are told. We have to set zero for by means of the coarse and the fine adjustment. You have to set zero the instrument using coarse and fine control knobs. And set next one, higher concentration. You have prepared how much the higher concentration? We have prepared 50 microgram per ml of sodium chloride. That you can keep and higher concentration, and you can make the fine and the knob and make it 100%. So that is the maximum, and this is the minimum, zero. And next, all the other concentration, if you keep, it will give you different reading. When you keep 10 microgram, it may give sometimes 8, 9, a same proportion. 20 may be giving 16 or 17, and 30 may be giving sometimes 25 or 26, and 40 may give sometimes 56 or something. So this you will give the spot in the graph by taking x-axis the concentration of various dilutions which you prepare in microgram, and you can take the y-axis as the light emission of the light intensity or the light intensity reading which is given in the digital display can be, or you can see absorption of the light you can write, because you can, because you are finding out by means of a photo multiplier tube, so you can write the emission of the light, emission of the light intensity, that is what the correct word which you can use for white y-axis, and plot the graph. As I told just now, x and y axis, the normal graph can be used and concentration of the solution. Now, your teacher might have given an unknown sample from this, or an experiment you can give. A series of students can be given one type of sample, another series of sample can be given to another sample, and we can even examine who is doing better and who is finding out. A skilled value can be also kept. It will be very interesting to do that. When you become, you can do this experiment even yourself. You can, because you know the answer by means of preparing an unknown sample, and you have to find out whether in the graph I am getting the same concentration, and that will be very interesting to be perform this experiment. And see, this is the graph which I am just, this is an graph which is taken from the internet, but anyhow, you can prepare your own graph, and you can see that is the spot which I have shown, that is unknown sample, which is highly concentrated unknown sample, which you see in the green color, directly extrapolating the into the x-axis, you can find out the concentration of the solution. So application, now just a theoretical, just for, you should not leave simply, so because it will be useful for the theory also. When you see this video, I feel that it should be helpful for the student in this COVID situation. So application of the flame photometry. Flame photometry can be applied for both quantitative and qualitative analysis of elements, and the presence of some group elements are critical, like sodium, potassium, lithium, all this calcium, all this in the soil health. We can determine the presence of various alkali and alkaline earth metals in the soil. So for agriculture purpose, also for analysis can be done. The sample can be conducted by means of flame testing, and then the soil can be supplied for a specific fertilizer. What type of fertilizer can be used can be decided by means of presence of elements in that soil. The concentration of sodium and potassium ions are very important in the human body, like urine, and conducting various metabolic functions can also be determined. The presence can be identified by this method, and this concentration can be determined by diluting and aspirating blood serum sample in the flame, also possible. And the soft drinks, in the soft drinks, fruit juices and alcoholic beverages can also be taken as a sample, also analyzed by using flame photometry. It can also be taken as a sample for the students, and it can be done as an experiment to determine the concentration of various metals which is present, and elements of this group 2 can be identified. Advantages of the flame photometer: you can see the method of analysis is very simple and economical, and it's quick and convenient, selective and sensitive analysis. And it's both and qualitative and quantitative analysis in nature can be done. And also even very low concentration, parts per million, that is ppm, parts per million, that means 1 microgram per ml or billion, parts per billion of the metals, can also be determined. Very minute concentrations can be determined in this method. This method component of any unexpected interferent materials present in the sample solution. So this compensates. For example, if there is any other interference, also can be overcome by this method. And this method can be used in estimatory elements which are rarely analyzed. Understand, rarely analyzed by other methods. So what is the disadvantages? Any experiments or anything, there will be disadvantages. Always there is a positive and negative. So what are the disadvantages for examination point of view? You have to know about that also. So in spite of many advantages, the analytical, that is analysis technique, has quite a few disadvantages, very few disadvantages. The accurate concentration of a metal ion in the solution cannot be measured. Accurate is not very accurately, we cannot find out, like which you are doing the sophisticated instruments, and it cannot be directly detected and determine the presence of inert gases. In the gases, if suppose any metals present, we cannot determine in the gases, only in the liquid. And through this technique, measure the total metal content present in the sample, and it does not provide the information about the molecular structure of the metal present in the sample. It doesn't give, only the amount of the metals can be determined. Only liquid samples may be used, that's what we told, gas cannot be used. Also, the sample preparation becomes lengthy in some cases actually, and flame photometry cannot be used to detect determination of each and every metal atoms. A number of metal atoms cannot be analyzed in a series by this method. The elements such as carbon, hydrogen and halides cannot be detected due to their non-radiation nature. That is just today I have added to say something to be a disadvantage. Thank you very much for being with me. Thank you very much. Please make use of this videos, and if possible, please subscribe my channel, and it will be helpful for me to do more and more. I will try to meet you in the next session.